In this video, I will walk you through an implementation of token-based authentication in Flask. There are several ways of implementing this functionality in your code, but this is one solution that I found to be rather easy to understand and secure. I have a new models.py file that contains the user model and the basic HTTP authorization code from the previous exercise. Here, I have a secret key, which is just a random string of 32 characters that I will use to sign my tokens. I will also make a new method here called generateAuthToken. I will make the token be an encrypted version of a dictionary that hides the ID of the user. The token will also have an expiration time embedded in it, which by default will be of 10 minutes, or 600 seconds. The verification is implemented in a verifyAuthToken static method. A static method is used because the user will only be known once the token is decoded. Now, in my views.py file, I'll make a new endpoint that the client can use to request a token. Note that this endpoint is protected with the auth.loginrequired decorator from Flask HTTP auth, which requires that the username and password are provided. Next, I'll add code for handling a token when my server receives one. The HTTP basic authentication protocol does not specifically require that usernames and passwords are used for authentication. These two fields in the HTTP header can be used to transport any type of authentication information. For token-based authentication, the token can be sent as a username, and the password field can be ignored. This means that now the server can authenticate requests with the username and password, and requests with just a token. The verify password callback needs to support both authentication styles. This new version of the verify password callback attempts authentication twice. It first tries to use the username argument as a token. If that doesn't work, then username and password are verified as before. I will run my web server again and send the following curl request in order to get an authentication token. I will run my web server again and send the following curl request in order to get an authentication token. Now the protected resource can be obtained authenticating with the token. Note that in this last request, the password is written as the word blank. The password in this request can be anything since it isn't used. The code and requests can be found in the instructor notes.